The NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series started only a short time ago in 1995, but ever since its first race at the Homestead Miami Speedway, it's been the fastest growing league in NASCAR. The popularity of the league has been attributed to many things: America's love of trucks, the competitiveness of the field. Why, some even think that since these trucks are a bit tougher than their shorter four-wheeled siblings, they're able to do more door-to-door racing than found in the more prestigious series. The start of this year's NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series is about to get underway at Daytona. One of the trucks to watch this year has to be the Sears Diehard Racing Team's number 202 ride, driven by none other than last year's reigning NASCAR Featherlite Modified champion. With success in both the modified league and on the dirt, the Sears Diehard team's confident that within a season or two, theirs will be the truck team to beat.
Welcome to Let's Play NASCAR Dirt to Daytona, part 47. Yeah, anyways, so it's truck series time, and one thing I forgot to show in the last career segment was my almanac for the previous season, so just showing off more stats in the weekly series. Feeling my bullshit. I got one pole position in 10 races as opposed to 2 in 6 in the dirt series. That's fucking lovely. And somehow ended up with a higher average finish as well, even though I won. How many races did I win? 8 races. Okay. But there's that. Then check out my modified stats. Big increase from the previous season, that's for goddamn sure. I got 3 poles, nice. 2 at the very end. And blah, 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 average finish 2.3, that's really good. So there's that. So now, we're going to go do truck shenanigans, and but first, I'm gonna show off something new. When you graduate to the truck series, this employees section is unlocked. And what you have here, you have 3 different team members you have to pay for, pretty much. A pit crew chief, a chassis builder, and an engine tuner for extra oomph. And each one has, you have to pay each person a certain amount of money per race. And here I'm just kind of looking at, here's contracts, pretty much upgrades of people, better people. But, you know, you gotta pay them more money per race, and there's a signing fee if you sign all of them, or somebody. I'm just gonna go ahead and get the best personnel. I know it's gonna cost me a lot of money each race, but it's gonna help me out. So I'm just gonna sign Buddy Barton here for $20,000 signing fee, $9,500 per race. And hey, Matthew Cato is the stock engine tuner. No, I'm getting Ed Chadwick. 10,000 raised, 25,000 sign fee. Alright. Well, I just spent a lot of money. So now let's go upgrade my truck. Except first, you notice I changed the liveries on my cars to match the truck. So let's just check out my truck livery for reference. Bam. There's that. So, I know you won't have to see this at all, but just to show off, here's my modified livery. I tried to make these look as close to the truck livery as I could with the templates I had. And finally, my dirt livery. There it is. Yeah. I don't know, I just felt like doing that because, I don't know, I just did. Instead of just having all black cars for whatever reason. So anyways, let's upgrade my truck now, because boy is it gonna need it. And first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get the best engine, VR3 Truck Elite engine. Ooh, 50 horsepower increase. And yeah, you see all the stats and shenanigans and shit. I don't really have to tell you all the fucking time. Let's get that, and I'm gonna go ahead and fully upgrade the exhaust as well for more power, because horsepower is kind of important for this first race. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. And finally, I'm gonna upgrade the aero. Let's see, how much money do I have? 11,000 or 111,000? Can't get the full upgrade. So I'll have slightly less rear downforce and a slight bit more drag. but I'm gonna go ahead and get this. Just cause why not? And there we go. So I got my truck upgraded as much as I can afford right now, so let's just go and actually start racing for our first race of the season, just overall, not just in the truck series. We're going to Daytona. Yeah, let's go. 50.057 was my qualifying lap, and it's good enough for sixth place. So yeah, this is why I went for just upgrading the absolute power of this truck first, because Daytona. So you see the field size has increased dramatically from 20 cars to 36 trucks, so yeah. There's that I have to deal with, and I'll get into more shit once we start the race.
Welcome to the Sunshine State and the birthplace of NASCAR, Daytona Beach, Florida. Since 1959, a driver's career can be made or broken at Daytona International Speedway. The 2.5-mile tri-oval has served as a proving ground for some of the greatest names in racing. 31 degrees of banking in the turns and incredible speeds on the straightaways have led to the inclusion of restrictor plates here. Aerodynamic drafting has become a must-have skill in order to stay with the pack and master Daytona.
Yeah, brief facts about Daytona. So just going through the starting grid here, note that there's a lot of real-life drivers finally, as opposed to just fantasy drivers. Also, I need to make note that pit road speed limit is 55 miles per hour. Because these races are quite a bit longer than the modified races, and since I had to pay for a crew chief and everything, there's going to be pit stops and plus the inclusion of drafting. And yeah, the fact that there's 36 trucks and we're at Daytona, so the draft is going to be a useful thing. And finally, rounding out the field in row 18, there we go. So here we go, 104 laps around Daytona for our first truck race of the LP. Off we go. Whoop. Already go down into somebody. Okay, I did not get nearly as good a launch as I was expecting. Maybe once I hit fourth gear, starting to move my way forward. And then I got blocked. Of course, he didn't really have a choice. Because this is Daytona. Carlo. Please do not push me into the wall. Fuck. Off.
Carlo.
Alright, we're off to a wonderful... No!
Car high.
God damn it.
All clear.
Well,
all clear.
There we go.
There's a spin in
I'm the greatest at starting races. I am the best there ever was. God damn it. I have a little bit of aero damage all around my truck. So yeah. That just happened. And we have our first caution, and because so there's something else new. I actually have flags. Yellow and black, but black flag is mostly just speeding on pit road, so that was a wonderful way to start the race. I could skip this caution and just go straight to the restart, but I kind of want to repair the damage I got from that shenanigans. Fucking... God damn it. That was the greatest way to start the race, I swear. And under caution, we actually get a lot of useful information just about who's running where in the race. Who's doing good, how many laps left, blah, blah, blah. My first fucking truck start, I cause a big wreck on the first lap. I hate starting on the outside so much, especially in higher speed situations like that. So yeah, I'm gonna opt to pit and just fully repair my truck, because it's gonna need it. I'm sure that aero damage, and I got a little bit of left front suspension damage. So, of course, the penalty of this is I'm going to start way in the back of the field, rendering my sixth place qualifying completely useless. So, yeah. I'm the greatest there ever was. Except I'm not. All right, truck's diving down into the pits. Got a couple takers. Maybe there's the 60 of, I think that's Brendan Gaughan? No. I think the 60 is Kvapil. Kvapil. However the fuck it's pronounced. All I know is that was the greatest slash worst way to start the fucking series. Oh, man. Gotta love how bad I am at things. It was just pretty much a chain reaction. I got fucking forced wide into the wall. I can barely fucking avoid shit on two lanes, let alone having only one lane. And it just kinda got worse from there. Alright, looks like my pit crew is really fast, so that's good. And repair time's done. That was only a less than 14 second pit stop. So at least I'm not going to restart in 36th, but yeah. So there we go. There's your first pit stop of the LP, and the first caution. I can't skip the rest of the yellow, so whatever, we'll just go with it. I'll just show off the full length of the yellow, just show what it's like, I guess. So, yeah. Bobby Hamilton moved up a few spots off the start. Good for him. John Wood, not so much. Went from 5th to 19th through the shenanigans I caused. Oops. Let's see, what position am I in? I'm in 30th, alright. So, 6 trucks behind me. So maybe I can get one full green flag or lap after this. At least one. More would be nice, just because, you know, racing. Duh. I think we're going to have one more lap of caution, so. Yeah, bear with me here. Don't worry. Every other caution that happens, I'm going to cut them out. I'm not going to particularly skip them because I want realism sake, but I'm going to cut out the cautions just for your sake. But yeah, I think we're going to have one more lap under yellow, so this is going to... Oh, okay, no we're not. Never mind. Here we go, we're getting ready to go racing. Maybe we'll actually go racing this time. Ugh. I'm still kind of, you know, punching myself in the back, punching myself for that. Now, if rules, if they implemented this rule in this game, I can only pass on the outside until I pass the line. Luckily, I don't get as good enough launch to make that even a possibility. So yeah, here we go. Do some actual. Racing now. Gotta remember, these trucks are a lot slower than mine.
Hold your line.
My goodness, 4 wide. I'm not good with being around other people, if you haven't noticed. Especially in this close proximity. So yeah, plate racing is probably my,
Hold your line.
Definitely my worst, thing. I'm just not good at it, holding my line. At all. I've made it up to 21st. I've actually passed a lot of trucks. I restarted in 30th. I've already passed 10 trucks.
All clear.
Drafting my way back towards the front.
Car low.
All right. Got one full green flag lap out of the way. We're good. Pass John Wood here. Maybe. Kind of running the really high line so I can get past this yellow truck. Forced out and god damn it. Have a repeat of lap one, except I got a lot of right front damages. Well, not a lot, but I got some right front damage this time.
Car low.
I don't know why I tried to block there. That was really stupid.
Carlo.
Hopefully I didn't hurt my performance much. And by performance, I mean speed.
All clear.
So yeah, three green flag laps, and twice I've hit the outside wall off of turn two. Fucking shit. Although it looks like I still have a good bit of straight line speed. Is he gonna save it? He's saved it. Barely saved it. I'm telling you, the closing rate on these trucks. Look at all those tire marks for me. But these trucks close in on it, or I close in on those trucks a lot. Okay, it definitely looks like my speed is affected. I cannot go quite as fast as I was, I don't think. Meanwhile, three wide up in front of me. Although I was trapped, yeah. I am still going a high rate of speed, plus I'm drafting, so I can't really gauge anything yet. Don't close this door, thank you.
Clear high. All clear.
Okay, so I've learned my lesson. Don't try to go three wide on the outside off a turn.
All clear.
Because the only thing that'll happen is I'll make more tire marks on the wall. And maybe a couple of trucks. Okay, those marks are not for me. Those are probably from that first lap crash, actually. Meanwhile, I've made it up to 12th position. Somehow, some way. And John Woods made it up from 20th to 11th. And looks like he's going after Schrader for 10th. I like Kenny Schrader. He's a cool guy.
That was your best lap ever.
Damn. Got a 49 with drafting there. I cut Schrader off.
All clear.
Alright. Let's just stick behind Wood here for a minute. And as we both make our way back towards the front. Stay off the wall. My truck's pulling to the right. I don't like that. Just kind of naturally does that. Alright, next up is Rich Bickle, running in 9th place in his completely unsponsored 15 truck.
Still there.
Please give me some room.
Clear low.
Also, one thing I think I was trying to mention at the start, but the wreck kind of interrupted that is, I did mention it in the Beat the Heat challenge, though. Or the Beat the Heat segment, though, is the spotter.
All clear.
You know, telling me where people are at all times.
Stay low.
So yeah,
still there.
Get to hear his voice throughout the rest of this LP. Just gonna try to push Matt Crafton along here. Maybe give me some kind of chance of making a pass.
Kind
of checking my damage. Whoop, whoop. A very slight contact with Hamilton there. Three wide, god damn it. That much I'm not really good at being around close proximity like this.
All clear.
That was a tight one. Hey, made it into the top five.
All clear.
Crashed my way into the top five. But I don't think I'm catching Rick Crawford up there without some kind of help. I'm getting a draft from the trucks behind me. But I'm also kind of pulling away from them. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Touch the apron. They're trying to keep up with me. They're probably succeeding. Yeah, they're definitely succeeding. By themselves, they are faster than me. Just a skosh. At least this isn't like, you know, actual Daytona racing where it's just fucking a madhouse. Because there's no way I'd survive that. Just absolutely no way. Okay, here comes Hamilton on to the back. Maybe he can give me a little push just to keep things going here. Tempted to just let him go around me and then try to push him. Because I'm a pretty good push drafter. At least I was in other games. Who knows, maybe the same can be said for this one.
Stay high, still there.
And just get him barely clear of me. There we go.
Still there.
Kind of had to lift off the gas there. Bonk. Probably shouldn't hit him that hard.
Still there.
Don't want to damage my truck more. So trying to keep this push going with my truck constantly moving to the right. Really goddamn annoying and difficult.
Still there.
It's slightly working. AI trucks don't seem to want to go much faster than they naturally can.
Still there.
Let's do this, because this has been such a good idea throughout this race.
Still there.
Fucking still there. Drag race.
Stay low. Still there.
Damn, we are completely even.
Stay low. Still there.
Okay, there we go. He's got a little more acceleration off the turn.
Still there.
And then we have 104 laps, or 104, yeah, 14 laps
stay
complete.
Low. Still there.
Out of 104.
Stay low. Still
I mentioned
there.
These races are a lot longer. Okay, well, I guess I'm just going to tuck in back behind him. Because Crawford is pulling away from us, so...
Still there.
Just going to have to dick around with Hamilton for a while. Go back and forth for fifth place.
Still there.
Oh, well, the fact that I have a fifth place truck here in my first race is... pretty fucking awesome, actually.
Still there.
Also, the fact that I've worked my way from 30th to 5th. In just a handful of laps is great.
Still there.
Pretty much I did as good as I could before this field got spread out.
Still there.
And we're inching away from Crafton and Wood, so I don't have to worry about them. Let's see, what's my fuel estimate? 25 laps? So that'd be what? Lap 31-ish, which I'm sure the estimate will be better than that. That's less than a third of the race. I'm sure I'm definitely going to go further than that on fuel. Yeah, that's another first. This is my first race in this game in the career mode on a track that's longer than a mile long, not counting Welch Valley.
Still there.
So first race on an oval longer than a mile. Longest prior was New Hampshire. Although technically it's longer than a mile, but it's like 1.033 or some stupid specific bullshit, so it's technically still a mile. give Hamilton a little nudge there.
Still there. Still there.
Yeah, be prepared to hear a lot of the spotter. Since, especially if I do have a... if I have enough to upgrade the handling on my truck. After this race. Oh man, what the hell happened to Wood? Oh. Like, what the hell happened to Wood? He's no longer in 8th place. Fucking fell back a little bit. Now him and Brendan Gaughan are fighting for position. And Crafton is just kind of slowly pulling away from them. How far behind the leader am I? Fucking almost 9 seconds, okay.
Still there.
Hey there, Bobby.
Still there.
How's it going? Not able to clear him at all, so... if I do... if this ends up being a final battle... final lap battle, I'm gonna have to make sure I get a run off this last turn. Cause I can't get enough momentum to pass him and clear him. Can scoot ahead barely, but not enough to clear him. Whoa, hitting the apron again.
Car high.
By barely scoot ahead, I mean like that. Damn, we were fucking... that was pretty much a tie, almost.
Still there. Still there.
Oh, hey. It's like Wood recovered from whatever the hell happened to him, and he's back... got past Crafton for 7th.
Stay low. Still there. Still there.
I can see Wood interrupting this battle. I think he's one of the faster trucks. He's closing the gap.
Still there.
Ever so slightly.
Still there.
All right, Bobby. I guess you're not appreciating this shenanigans we're doing. It's pushing me way down low.
Still there. Still there. Still there.
Just push him along down the back. Oh yeah, Wood is definitely catching us. Laps complete. Man, we've already run 21 laps. It feels like I haven't been racing for very long, but yet I have. But again, it's only been 21 laps. We still have a long fucking way to go. Here with this dumb move down the back. Ooh, clear him. I cleared him.
Clear high.
Okay, I was far enough behind on the exit of 2 where I had a lot of momentum. See if I can keep him behind me. Because I'm actually getting a really nice push from him. Man, that 50 truck is catching us and quick. Keep it off the wall. I'm trying to get a push from Bobby, but I'm also trying to, you know, not touch anything. Eighty laps to go. Looks like we're reeled in some backmarker trucks. That's going to be fun. And I am 12 seconds behind the leader. Also, I have very little tire wear. I'm most likely going to take two tires on my first pit stop, or second pit stop, actually. Since, you know, I pitted under that caution that I caused and stuff. Anyways. This two-truck battle for fifth has turned into a three-truck battle. It's a catch first back marker, 36th position. Unless somebody's retired, which I don't know. Haven't been paying attention to the pit area. Just try to get around this guy smoothly.
Still there.
Gave me no room. Get out of the grass. Okay. We're good.
Car high.
Everything's fine. Everything's fine. Just gotta recover. Just chill behind Wood for this turn. Everything is A-okay. Motherfuckers give me absolutely no room off of two. It's really annoying.
All clear.
Okay, Hamilton's stuck behind this guy, so I'll just go around all three of you.
All clear.
Take fifth place back after that fucking heart attack. Okay, so don't try to pass back markers or anybody around the outside. Especially around turns 1 and 2. Unless I have the momentum to clear them before we exit 2. Truck.
Still there.
Get him on the trioval around the outside at least. Ooh, that was close to the apron. That was really close. Got Mr. Wood quickly catching me. Bobby's falling behind. Oh, yep, he got underneath, okay. Spotter was not lying.
Still there.
Okay, well, Wood definitely has a fast truck.
Stay high, still there.
But he got boxed in. So I will take the position back for now. 75 to go. So how many laps have we completed? 29. All right, I've still got quite a handful of laps before my second pit stop. Man, John really likes that bottom lane right now.
Still there. All clear.
Ooh, that was really close to the wall. Okay, gonna try to clear him before the exit.
Still there.
And got him.
You're all clear.
Good. Or else I would have had another fucking... Yeah. Fucking turn two is calamity corner for me. That's for damn sure. Of course, all these slow trucks are the fantasy drivers. No surprise at all. So that's 31 laps complete.
Still there. Clear high.
Tell you what, the draft is really effective in this game. And they're trying to make a move on the exit too. Fucking denied because I'm an asshole. Looks like Crawford was having some issues getting around these two trucks, because... Oh, and he's going to pit. Alright. So I think our first pit stop cycle is underway. Yep. Most of the trucks have... Most of the trucks in front of me have pitted. So now I just gotta wait for Crawford to pit, and then I'll stay out, get a lap led, or get 5 points for leading a lap, and I guess I'll pit. This was a bad idea. I should have known better. Should have known better. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna just stay out one lap after Crawford pits, which should be this time now. Since I'll be on the same cycle as the leaders. And I'll get 5 points for leading the lap. There we go. Huzzah. Now the real test. Can I enter pit road without crashing? That's a pretty difficult task, I'm not gonna lie. For me, anyways. I'm gonna try. And I am gonna repair my little bit of damage, so that'll cost me a couple seconds. Okay, let's slow it down. I'm just taking it nice and easy. Alright, there we go. And two cans of fuel, I'm just taking right size, repair the damage. Don't care about grill tape or frickin' wedge, because I forget which way wedge tightens or loosens the truck. Alright, so an extra 2 seconds almost for repairs, which is done. There we go. Damn, that was for two cans of fuel as well. That was pretty fucking short. See, I just took right side tire since I had very little wear. And after my pit stop, let's go to the cockpit camera for a bit. Because... gotta show it off. I mean, if it has a, the game has a cockpit camera, I can't not show it off. This is the first time seeing it in the truck series, so yeah. This is what I'm gonna do, just each pit stop I'm gonna alternate between the cockpit and the chase camera.
Car high.
That is... Brendan... No, that was Kvapil. Trying to get around me. Okay, so I've been cycled back to 8th position for now, but I don't think everybody's made their pit stops yet. There we go. Almost all my damage is gone, except for that little bit of front end damage. But apparently it's just irreparable. And back up to 6th. Behind Small. So I wonder where Wood is. Oh my goodness, alright. Getting a little close to that outside wall here, entering these turns. Oh, more pit stops. And I'm up to 4th. I think my two-tire strategy helped me out there. Put me from battling for 5th to clearly in 4th. Bizarre. Yeah, everybody is pitted. 12 seconds back from the leader. Get a little draft off this slow truck. Okay, so everybody was in around 34 to 37. So about the third distance part, point.
Car high. All clear.
I think some people are trying to do the little backward strategy of pitting as early as possible and then stretching it to the end. So let's see, how's my tires? Yeah, my left sides have almost no wear. I'm kind of tempted to just do two tires for my remaining stops. Which there should be only one more. Because this is after, you know, a third of the race and barely have any wear.
The car head is pitting.
Grip isn't really that important around here. Since our trucks aren't insanely fast. I mean, they're fast. We're going, you know, 180-plus miles per hour. But, yeah. It's Daytona. We don't need grip, okay? Okay. I'm not even turning the wheel all the way. By the wheel, I mean stick. Yeah, there's John Wood. He's back in 6th. Somehow ended up behind Crawford. No, wait, that's right, because Crawford was in front of me, and now, because of my two-tire stop, he's behind me. Okay. So everybody ended up where they were, except me. Because I decided to be a cool kid. Angela Crawford is catching me to no surprise. Oop. Jerked the wheel a little too much there. So yeah, I'm lapping at my qualifying pace right now. Pretty much. Maybe a slight bit slower. You know, within a few laps, that 14 truck will be all up on my ass. Sixty-two laps remaining. Only have 10 laps from halfway, so making pretty good progress. Currently lapping at 50.3, and what, my qualifying was a 50 flat, I think. So just 3/10 off of my original pace. It's not that bad here at Daytona. Here comes Crawford. I see him in my mirror. Getting a little draft from the truck up in the head. Up in the head. Up in the head. See how well I deal with lap traffic in this camera. Sure, not very well. Okay, well, this guy's gonna give me the inside, which is really nice.
Still there. You're all clear.
Yay. All the way down to the very bottom of the circuit. Boy, these two are going at it for position. This is going to be interesting. Excuse me, pardon me, coming through here, don't mind me. That went extremely well. Yeah, expect a lot of green flag racing, because I don't think the AI really fucks up that often, if at all. Okay, well, after that minor setback, here comes Crawford again.
Car high. All clear.
So yeah, as long as things keep going as well as they are, my pursuit to be pretty much the Mark Marquez of this series, it's going to start off really well. And for those who don't know, Mark Marquez, he won the 2013 MotoGP Championship in his rookie season, nonetheless. I still cannot wrap my brain around that one. Just how the fuck he'd managed to do that. But yeah, and here's the 14 finally. I kind of just want to fuck around with them and just keep blocking them. Oh shit. Okay. Fucked up my steering input a little bit there. So I guess I'm not going to block them for a bit. Nope. I'm going to wreck them though.
Still there.
Whoa, hey truck, how you doing? Take her easy. Come on. Let's catch back up to Crawford. Don't want to lose him.
Still there.
Fuck it. Can I clear him? Yes. Now let's try to block him a bunch. Just try to keep him behind me.
Stay low. Still there. Clear low.
He said clear low. He was... Sometimes the audio slightly glitches and says the wrong thing. Nothing is perfect, goddammit. I wonder how much time behind the leader I am. 15 seconds. Wait, what did he say about that lap? I don't even know. Somebody said something. I know we're not halfway through the race, because there's still 54 to go. Man, Crawford's having all kinds of trouble getting by that guy. Three laps of fuel, that'll take me to what, 50, whoa, not 50, 73, which is plenty of time before the end, or to make it to the end. I'm not going to do anything super risky with my pit stop, just going to get most likely two tires, considering my left sides are holding up very well. So two tires, two cans of fuel, and repair what damage I may have gotten during this stint. Full throttle racing at Daytona, da-na-na-na-na-na-na.
Okay, that's the halfway mark.
Now we're halfway through the race. 52 down, 52 to go. in my truck debut. Hello. Quite a few trucks up ahead. Oh, keep it down low. So Crawford doesn't get inside of me. Truck exiting the pits, alright. Please do not go down to the bottom. Thank you.
Still there. You're all clear.
Two down, two to go in this little group of trucks. Well, this guy was running down low, then he decided to move up. Come on, clear him. Alright. Found that out myself. A little late to the button, buddy. Going underneath. Oh, going down on the apron. All right. Good thing there's no out-of-bounds shenanigans programmed into this game. Man, through those four trucks, I pulled out almost 2 seconds on Crawford. Just from passing people. The gap to the leader, 17 seconds, so he hasn't really gained that much time on me throughout this stint. Doesn't matter, there's no way in hell I'm winning this race, even with a caution. Okay, maybe with a caution I would have a chance, but still. That'd mean I'd be starting on the outside, and well, if the race start is any indicator, that would be a bad thing, and somebody just blew up, I believe. Dude, that was the 90 truck, I think. I know he was... Hey!
All clear. Yellow's out. Space car's out.
Almost got fucking wrecked. Also, there's the caution. Every time I try to pass somebody on the outside of turn two, that just an wreck almost happens. Also, I think the truck that almost wrecked me did wreck himself. And the 90, I think, of Lance Norrick. He was running in second or third. But, he's out of the race. So, caution number two. Caused by me again, I'm sure. I don't really know. There is no, like, actual caution replay. So I'm just kind of go through little stats here. 45 laps remaining. God, this restart is going to suck balls. There's your lap leaders. Presley, Small McDonald, me with one lap. Presley has just dominated this race, and he'll probably continue to do so. Let's see, there's 40-some laps to go. I might be able to make it on fuel. This is going to be a fuel mileage race now. So yeah, I'm going to pit. And, I'll just cut out this half lap and meet you in pit lane. Well, here we go. It's pit stop time, and I was the only person to duck down, so this is definitely going to be a big gamble. I think since nobody's pitting this caution, I will have a leg up, so if I do need to get fuel, I can just come in for a quick splash, and that'll give me a big advantage, probably. I don't know. We'll just see what happens, but there we go. And I took four tires instead of just two, just so I can have fresh tires for the restart, because why not? So there we go. And I'm going to restart in 12th position unless somebody in front of me pits, which I don't know why they would, so... Cutting to the restart. Okay, so we're rounding turn four, I believe. Yep, pace car just went off. I just wanted to take a little extra time here to explain the restart format of this game. For those who may or be a little newer to watching NASCAR, the old restart format, which is shown in this game, is all the everybody on the lead lap starts on the right lane, and everybody one or more laps down starts in the left lane. So even though I'm in 12th position, I'm starting in 24th. Restarting in 24th. Of course, the worst part is the fact that I am starting on the outside.
Hold your line.
And I guess we're going three wide. And I'm just going to stick with the cockpit cam until we get going. I almost got turned. This exit is going to suck. I'm not even going to attempt to do anything three wide related. Gonna go like a herp.
Still there.
Jeez. Another curse of being on the outside. Just nowhere for me to go. With all this momentum. Ah, there's the wall.
Still there. Car low.
Okay, I'm gonna switch cameras now since clear I made low. My pit stop. That's what I said I was gonna do. Oh my goodness! Whew, I'm making really risky fucking moves here. I kind of have to.
All clear.
Okay. Please be nice to me, Mr. Crafton. Thank you for giving me plenty of room. Oh, this is not good. I have nowhere to go. So let's push the middle lane, because that's a good idea, right?
All clear. Car low.
Oh, no. Just force my way through the middle, don't mind me. Oof, oof, oof.
Still there.
Did I mention these moves are quite risky? Oh, oh. 18 truck got a little squirrely there.
Still there.
Robert Presley. Three wide still.
Car low.
Come on, can I fit? Can I fit?
Car low.
I fit. Alright. Squeeze in between the 15 of, I think, Bickle and Schrader.
All clear.
Hey, I'm in second place. Well, I said if I got a caution, that'd give me another shot at the win. But that would give me a shot at the win, and here it is. Me and the 07 is small. Who apparently is also a rookie. But still 39 laps to go, and now...
Still there.
Here's the situation with my fuel. There's no way I'm going to make it the rest of this race on without stopping. Like, 45 laps, although three of those were under caution. That caution lasted three laps, because with pit stop cycles, all the lead lap trucks pit first lap, and then the second lap, the lap trucks pit.
All clear.
But, yeah, what was I gonna say? But yeah, trying to go fucking 42 green flag laps on a full tank of gas around here, I don't think that's gonna happen. But like I said, I can just squeeze and throw it into the pits and get like just a little splash of gas and I'll be good. Some point here. Okay, well, I'm gonna have a lot of trucks on my ass if I keep this up, because I don't think the speed I gain through being pushed is gonna help me pull away from anybody, or help us pull away from anybody, so yeah. And I have a couple trucks on my ass here. But oh, what a feeling it would be if I won this race. Still without the best equipment. Alright, let's block Presley, get a push from him. Presley definitely has the fastest truck in this field. If there's anybody I want to try to keep behind me, it's him. And he's pitting. Okay. I guess it is the getting close to the end of the second pit stop cycle. Since I was the only one to go in under that caution, so yeah. Wonder how that's going to work itself out. But now it's back to me and small. Not even beginning the second pit stop cycle. It's only lap... No, wait, it is. Lap 69. That was lap 59 for some reason. I can't fucking read that. I'm too far away from my TV. I can't fucking see that small text. And more trucks pitting. So I'm kind of going to be left alone here. For a while, and that's probably going to severely hurt my chances of winning, because they'll reel me in by being faster. But we'll see what happens. Either I'm going to win this race and barely on fucking sputter to the line, or I'm probably maybe squeeze out a top five, I don't know, with a splash. Either way, it'll be a good start, since there's only 12 trucks on the lead lap. I can't really finish that far down the order. Oop. Touched the apron. And through the fracas at the restart, got a little bit of damage, but it's fine. So I'm six laps shy. Six laps short on fuel. Like just three more trucks behind me that need to pit. So yay. Our first fucking race with pit stops and cautions and shit, and it turns down into a fuel mileage race caused by a caution on Chin. Don't you love this? God damn it. Oh well, it keeps it at least mildly interesting. I love how the timer just goes apeshit crazy when somebody's going it slowing down for the pits. Alright, so Presley's 36 seconds behind me. I'm running 50.3s on my own, and I almost wrecked there. So I wasn't paying attention to where I was trying to look at my time. There's a lot of trucks up there I really want to catch up with, but I don't think I'll be able to. If I end up with a drafting buddy through this, that'll really help me out. Okay, well, everybody's cycled through. Presley's back in second. Now it's a 50.5 because of, well, still recovering from that near spin. Well, looks like I'll have a few back markers to draft off of, maybe. For a split second.
Still there. All clear.
Oh, this is gonna be an interesting finish. See what my estimated fuel is now. 24 laps. And there are 30 to go, so still 6 laps short. I don't think that's going to change. Less than 30 to go, oh my god. Gotta draft him as long as possible.
Still there. You're all clear.
Oh, and caution, okay. Well, that throws that out of the window. Shit. Well, at least I can pit to give me enough fuel to go to the finish. So yeah, there goes the strategy and trying to stretch fuel mileage.
four cars headed into the pit.
Oh man, Hamilton's, I guess, blown up.
Space cars out.
Alright, slow it down, just lift off the gas here. Since everybody does before they get to the line. Okay, well. Now what do I do? Actually, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go in the pits. I'm gonna get four tires. I'm gonna repair damage. I'm gonna get half a can of fuel. Just enough. Half a can is all I need. So I'll restart in probably 11th place, since Hamilton is probably out of the race, I'm guessing. So yeah, I don't know what, something happened to Hamilton. He brought out the caution. So there's what's been going on in this race. So yeah, cutting to the pit stop. And unsurprisingly, I'm the only truck to pit, since everyone else is good to go to the end. I think what I am going to do is I'm going to put a little, just add 10% tape to my grill. Maybe give me a little more straight line speed. Hopefully it won't fuck my engine up. It probably won't. So, it's a good thing I hired that good crew chief, because damn, these stops are lightning quick, even with the repairs. That was less than 13 seconds. That's pretty fucking awesome, so gonna exit and restart in 11th position. Well, here we go. Alright, here we go. 24 laps to go. It's fucking on. Shit. Okay, well, I guess I'm driving through the pit lane. Well, that's not the way I wanted to restart the race. It certainly was fucking on, and then now it's off. Unless I get another caution, there went my chance at winning. I was trying to work my way down to the bottom, and apparently somebody was in my way. So that didn't exactly work itself out, now did it? So what turned into what could have been a top 5 finish to a victory is, unless another caution happens, I'll be lucky to get a top 10. And I was just kind of using the cockpit camera to try to get a better restart going. But see how well that went. So here we go, 23 laps to go. Probably should not have added that grill tape. Truck's running 202 degrees. I don't know what is too hot, so. Hopefully I'll be safe.
Still there. Clear low.
Finally caught back up to the end of the field. Truck way on the bottom.
Car high. Oh. You're all clear.
Got pushed
all
down clear. To the apron. Oh my goodness.
Car low.
A lot of trucks. Excuse me, pardon me.
Clear high.
Can't afford to waste any time if I want to get a good finish, or a better finish.
All clear.
Oh! Well, there we go. Tried something that did not work. The apron got me. I tried to make a move. The apron got me. Oh. Well, there we go. Alright, guess I'm not finishing in the top 10. Unless another caution happens, which, the way I'm driving right now is a good possibility. Okay, well, I guess whatever what happened to Hamilton wasn't terminal for his truck, so probably just looped it around or something. I love choking.
low. Clear low.
All I had to do was get a good restart, and guess what didn't happen?
All clear.
So now I have to worm my way through these guys again. Clear low. Fuck this, I'm going on the apron.
Car high. 20 to go.
I don't even care, it's not out of bounds in this game, I don't care. I want to at least try to get a top 10 finish. I don't think I can do as good as I was earlier since the field's pretty kind of starting to spread out now.
Car high.
I can't do anything about that. Why'd you do that?
Clear high.
I wanted that lane, but no. Close the door. How's my temperature, by the way? 210.
Still there.
11. Actually, I'm going to keep an eye on this. I think that was my best lap of the race. Just because of all the drafting I've been doing. Alright, I'm going to... Well, I said I was going to risk it, but no. The wall had other plans. It's probably a good thing that I didn't. Or a good thing that happened. I didn't even get damage from that. How is this Setzer? How close am I to Setzer? God damn it. Alright. Right behind Dennis Setzer for 10th place, so that's good. Just keeping an eye on my temperature still. Almost reaching 190.
Still there. All clear.
So close to 190, but not quite. Well, I made it into the top 10. I don't think I'm going to do any better. Maybe. I'm ever so slightly closing in on McDonald, it looks like. Of course, he's trying to go around the back marker. Eight seconds out of lead. I just really want another caution to happen so I can maybe redeem myself. But I know it's not. So I guess now the agenda is squeeze out as good of a finish as I can get. So close to getting a draft off that truck up ahead. Just not quite there. Oh, I'm getting something. I saw that blue. At least my pace is up, about where it was in qualifying. So, oh shit, I think the increased grill tape counterbalanced the damage I've taken from that restart. Still keeping a close eye on my engine temps because I don't know what is in the bad per se. too hot. That's what I'm trying to say. I don't know, but I'm closing in on McDonald for ninth position. Yeah, I can slingshot by him and have enough momentum to barely catch up with Gaughan and fight for 8th, 7th. One time somebody doesn't go extremely wide off turn 2.
Clear high.
Okay, well into 9th place. Still have a lot of momentum. It isn't enough to catch the end of Gaughan's truck and get a draft. Just barely. On. If I can catch them, I may have that top 5 finish is still within my grasp. I think there's a couple lap trucks in that kerfuffle, so. So a top 5 is probably out of the question, but I can still get a good finish. Get solidly into the top 10 instead of barely.
Stay high, still there.
How you doing, Mr. Crafton?
Still there.
A dozen laps to go. There's a truck exiting the pits. Okay.
Still there.
And he's got the advantage on me now. See what happens down straightaway. See what Lane Wapple takes. And Crafton's got the draft. If I can squeeze him down a little bit and get some of it.
Still there.
Got a skosh of it right at the end of the straightaway. Meanwhile, Hamilton's just kind of chilling here.
Stay high. Still there.
Oof, that was kind of close. Oh yeah, one thing I just remembered about cautions also, if you're semi-new to NASCAR, instead of caution just stopping all racing immediately, back here in the year 2002, I believe, is when this game was released or something, the field would not slow down until... the field was allowed to keep racing until they crossed the line.
Clear high.
Once the yellow had been drawn. Made for some dangerous situations, and then they immediately changed that rule after Dale Jarrett almost got fucked up while people were racing to the caution. I think it was Jarrett that happened to. But yeah, there's that. One position away from the top 5. If I can just get a caution, I'll stay out. And there'd be under 10 to go. And the old caution rule, if there's a restart within 10 laps to go, it's a single file restart regardless of who and how many people are a lap or more behind. They just go behind the leaders instead of beside them. So yeah, if we got another caution, I wouldn't even have to deal with that shit. And I would have a really good shot at winning. I wish somebody behind me, directly behind me, is a little bit faster. like I'd do some drafting shenanigans to maybe catch Daughter, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. Also, I don't know if it'll ever happen to me, but I think there's a slight glitch with this game where if the yellow comes out and you cross the line before the leader does, basically if the yellow comes out in between, like if the leader has already completed his lap and you're about to complete that lap, but if the yellow comes out in between that time, the game will give the AI control, but they'll still go at race pace. But you will lose control of your truck, base or vehicle, truck or car, depending on what series it is. But yeah, there's that. Ooh. Looks like Bobby Hamilton has some speed after whatever the fuck happened to him. Maybe he can help me out. You know, Kropel and Crafton are just going at it for 7th. Come on, Bobby, give me a push. Don't be a bitch, give me a push. Help a brother out, man. Well, he's helping me out, but it's not nearly enough. Uh-oh. Presley blew up. Oh my god. Fastest truck in this race, and he just blew up with 5 laps to go. That's fucking depressing. Like, I feel bad for him. It's gonna give me a top 5 finish, but I feel bad that I have to get it in that way. I guess technically if I'd be in 7th place had there not been, Presley now and then Lance Norrick way back earlier in the race. Okay, here comes Hamilton again. Maybe Daughter can get held up by the slow truck that I think he's approaching. It won't happen, but, you know. Or if he does, he won't get held up enough. Damn, Hamilton's booking it right now. Also shifting lanes like an asshole. Trying to get the AI to cooperate with you is not an easy feat. Okay, should be two to go, I think, this time across the line.
Two to go.
Yep, two more to go at Daytona. Doesn't look like Daughter's going to get held up by that slow truck either. Oh, there's two of them, maybe. Oh, yep, he's getting bogged down. This may be an opportunity. Although he's going around him now, down the back. I think it's just too little, too late. Although I'm getting ever so slightly closer. Get a nice pull
last
from that
lap.
Guy.
Stay low. Still there. Clear high.
I don't think, I won't get enough to reach him, maybe. Although he's stuck behind another truck. All right. Here we go. I might gain one more position before this race is over. Oh, I'm catching him quickly.
Clear high.
All right, Mr. Daughter. Let's do this.
Still there.
Off the last turn. Rough him up a little bit. He's going to have to run, though. All right. Well, I got a top five finish. So, that's still not bad. And I ended up scoring the fastest lap of the race when I was recovering from that last restart. That's pretty great. All right. Well, there we go. That was my truck debut at Daytona. I managed to lead 14 laps and got a top five. So, huzzah. Okay, so the replay glitched on the restart, so I guess I'm only showing that, that one lap of the replay. Because on the restart, it decided to make my truck go down into the grass in the tri-vol and come up and wreck somebody, and then come back down and slam the inside wall and fuck the engine up. I don't fucking know. But here we go. There's our final results, and what the fuck happened to Presley? Because he didn't retire from the race. Maybe he just had to make an emergency pit. I don't fucking know. Whatever it was, it prevented him from winning, and it gave me a top five finish. So, just go down the rest of the running order. You can pause, I guess, at your leisure and take a closer look at it. Five trucks retired from the race. So, yeah. So, there we go. That was my truck debut. Got a top five finish. Not bad. And I had a chance to winning. But, my shitty oh, no. Well. That's not good at all. It'll probably help when I get, like, sponsorship money, but holy shit. I lost $4,000. Okay. That's okay. Well, at least, so yeah. Maybe the sponsors, like I said, will probably counter that. Hopefully, I fucking hope so. If not, I might have to invest in a different crew member or something, I don't know. But anyways, there's the points and shit. I know I kind of went through that quickly, my bad. Yeah, there's that. Fifth place, five bonus points, and start with a tie for fourth with a daughter. So we were very close in the finish. We end up tied in the point standings after one race. See, where's Presley's? 10th in points because he got 10 points really in the most laps and just leapfrogged Setzer. And there we go. Apparently there's two other truck drivers. Hold on. So, Yeah, let's see what kind of sponsor offers I get. Win the fastest lap, that's not gonna happen. Win the race, that's not gonna happen for a while. Top 10 I can definitely get. So I'll sign with these guys. And I'll just leave that alone. Cause I highly doubt I'm gonna, you know, win and shit. So yeah, I lost $4,000 from that race because of crew expenses. I don't know. I'm just taking a look here. Maybe I should get a shittier pit crew. I don't know. I can probably make up for it on the track, but I don't know. No, it doesn't matter. I'll deal with that later. But I'm going to be doing the dirt modified races to make more money anyway, so looks like we have quite a few of them in between truck races, so yeah, that was that. First truck race. Qualified 6th, finished 5th, and lost $4,000. Stay tuned for more Dirt to Daytona.